Hello everyone, welcome again. So in the previous video I explained what is priority queue. So priority queue is a kind of queue where elements are ordered according to their priority, not like normal queue where the order is maintained as first in first out. So here the order is maintained as whatever is the priority of their elements. So priority queue, what we saw in the previous video, is it is internally using this heap data structure to implement it. So now in our day-to-day program, priority queue is heavily used. So each and every time we will not create the priority queue and its behavior from scratch. So that's why in Java, priority queue comes as a class. As an inbuilt class, we will get priority queue and we can use it. So how it is placed in Java and what is the use and what are the feature of it, we will see next. Priority queue in Java comes under Java util package as Java util.priority queue. So if you look at this diagram and its hierarchy, so this Java util priority queue actually extends Java util abstract queue class, which implements Java util queue interface. And this Java util queue extends java.util collection interface. Another point is it is unbounded queue based on priority heap. So what is unbounded queue means? Unbounded means which are not bounded by capacity. That means we will not specify the size of the queue. So generally all queues which are available in Java util package are unbounded in nature. Another point is a priority queue does not permit null elements. Now we will go to the editor and we will play with priority queue and its basic properties. Now we will see how we will implement priority queue and what are its uses. So here I have created one class called priority queue in Java, and inside this main method I have initialized this priority queue. So if you hover on here, you can see it's a Java util priority queue of type integer. So here type integer means only integer values are allowed inside the priority queue. And after that I have added few elements to this priority queue: 12, 21, 3, 45, 1 and 20, 101. Now as I have inserted all these elements in the priority queue, now if I iterate over that, what result it is showing, I have to check now. So if I run this, I can see whatever value I have inserted, it is now forming one order: 1, 3, 12, 45, 21, 101 and 20. But I have inserted 12, 21, 3 in this order. So if you check closely, this is nothing but a min heap, as I have shown here. So priority queue by default act as a min heap. Whatever value you will insert in maybe whatever order, it will create a min heap internally. Now how I can use this priority queue as a max heap? Means how I can tell this priority queue, like I want a max heap output out of it. For that purpose I need a comparator class to be defined. Why? Because this priority queue don't know like how to compare between these objects. Either it's an ascending order or descending order. I have to explicitly tell this one. When only it will act as a max heap or min heap. By default it will act as a min heap. But if we have to make it act as a max heap, that time I have to pass one comparator class also with it, which will internally
overwrite the compare method, and two argument will be integer a and b. If I do a b minus a, that means it will sort in descending order. And by default, it is actually a minus b in case of main heap. Now, the same values, I will remove this space, and we can compare side by side. So now if you see, same elements I have inserted in this max heap also, which is a priority queue with the comparator, where actually I told him to in descending order to sort. Now it's 12, 21, 3, 45, 1, 101 and 20. And if I iterate over it, and run it, what I can see is it is forming a max heap. So this way we can decide like how to create a priority queue as a max heap, or by default it will be a min heap. Now we will check for one more property which we explained earlier, that is null values are not allowed in a priority queue. So this 12, I will change it to null. And we will see what is the result. So if we run this one, it is showing a null pointer exception. Okay, at line number 12. So that's why you can compare here also, like null values are not allowed inside a priority queue. Because if I pass null, then what to compare there? That's why nulls are not allowed in a priority queue. Now we will talk about few operations which we can perform on a priority queue. One is peak operation, one is pole operation. Peak operation means it will just return the root node, or in case of min heap, the minimum value, and for max heap, the maximum value, but it will not delete anything. So if you go to peak method, what it is saying, like it retrieves but does not remove the head of this queue, or return null if the queue is empty. Okay. For pole operation, everything is similar to peak. It will also return the root node. But in this case, it will remove and then return. That means if we go to pole operation, it is showing it retrieves and removes the head of this queue, and return if the queue is return null if the queue is empty. Okay. Now we will see how it is behaving. So I have taken one priority queue of integer. As I have not passed any comparator, that means by default it is a min heap, and I have added these elements to this queue. Now I am doing a peak operation and printing that, and then I will iterate over it to check something is removed or not. And in another scenario, I am just calling this pole method and printing what it returns, and after that I am running an iterator over it to check if all these values are present or something got removed or not. So now I am running this. So after running, what I can see is for peak operation it returned 1, that was the lowest value because it was a min heap or the root element, but the array is same, means all the elements are present. We have total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 elements. Here also if you see, 7 elements are present, nothing got deleted. But when we did one pole operation, that time it returned the root node or the lowest element. But side by side, it removed also. So now this 1 is not present in this heap or priority queue anymore. So now it is 3, 20, 12, 45, 21, 101. And we can see as 1 is removed, it has changed also. It is not like this remaining portion, because after 1 is removed, again this queue heapify itself to adjust it nodes to behave as a main heap. So what we have seen till now is, we used integer or string as a priority queue element, But for some of our purpose, we maybe need to insert a whole object as an element in the priority queue. Suppose I have a class student, which has instance variables as name and roll number, and this is the Pojo class. So I need this student to be inserted in the priority queue. So, and to use this roll number field as a priority, means if I have roll number field less, then it will be of highest order. If the roll number is more, then it will be a lowest order, that sequence. So what we can do for that, means how we can implement that thing. So this class I have defined separately. Now in the main method, I can define the priority queue. And here we can pass generic as student. And we can mention like eq student equal to new priority queue student. Okay. Now what we can do is we can add few new students inside this. So we can do new student and we can put name as ABC and roll number as 10. Then we can add two more. TTY or something, and we can give roll number as 7, and here we can give roll number as 19. Now I have created this priority queue, and the generic or student type is, means the generic type is student. So now what will happen? So I can maybe print something. I can print the pick method here, like what actually it is returning. We can check. So if I do pq student dot pick here, then what it will return? As it's by default a min heap, then the lowest roll number, this 7, will be returned, this element. And as I have the two string method overridden, so I can print that object also. So let's run it. So what we can see here, it is showing Java lang class cast exception. Heap student cannot be cast to Java lang comparable. So why this error is coming? Because we just told that the priority will be defined based on roll number. But where we define that one? It will not by itself, it we can take what we are thinking, right? So we have to define somewhere, and we have to tell this priority queue that compare the students based on their roll number. So for that purpose, what we can do is we have to implement the comparable method here. Sorry, comparable interface, which will take student as, and obviously it will throw some error because that compared to method we have to implement here. So if I do add an unimplemented method, then it will override the compared to method. Okay, and the comparison we have to do now based on roll number. So what we can do for that is we can return this dot roll minus o dot roll. So o dot get roll we will use. And if we do a comparison now, then we can see it is behaving properly and it is returning me roll number 7. That is the lowest roll number as the highest priority here. But if we want 19 to be returned, means highest roll number will have the highest priority. That time we can just remove this portion and we can reverse this order. Means O dot get roll number minus this dot roll number we can do. That's the reverse of this thing. Then if we run, it will return 19. Means the highest roll number will have the highest priority. And we can use several combinations also. Suppose in roll number, then date of joining, then date of birth. Combination of those also we can use as a priority. So that thing we have to define here. Okay, like how we want to define the priority to be compared. So this is all about priority queue and how we can use this one. It has also a lot of other methods also, but whatever I have shown is the few popular methods which we use. So for solving any problems by heap data structure, if we are implementing it in Java, then we can directly use priority queue, because priority queue is nothing but a heap. Okay. Thanks for watching, and I will share this code also in the link section.